Good afternoon, YouTube. What's going on? It's Mesa back at it with some Destiny. I got a number of things I want to cover in this video, and one of them is going to be some clues regarding the old raids coming back, and I really do think we're going to get those. I've discussed that a number of times on Guardian Radio and in previous videos, but also I want to talk about a cool idea that I have that, man, if they could do this, it would really build up the hype for the full-blown sequel to Destiny. So I reported in a previous video that just a number of things, when the dawning hit the database, and they were all classified. And it says all will be revealed in time, young Padawan. So I was poking around Reddit, and some people have the hypothesis that perhaps those are literally all the items from the old raids, meaning old raids coming back, so forth. Okay, but then I think a few people debunked it because the numbers didn't add up, but I certainly don't think that those are just all brand new weapons or brand new gear coming with some sort of April update, because it was about 40 or 50. I don't know the exact number, but definitely over 50. I believe it was over 50 items that are showing up as classified. You know, back in the day when we saw the Astrocyte Verse, Transverse of Steps, Shinobu's Vow, those showed up in the armory, and then quickly they were turned to classified. So I don't think those are all exotics, but I got a feeling that those could be stuff from, well, if they bring the old raids back. And are those going to be new weapons? I don't think so. I think if they were to bring back the old raids, they would just bring back the old raid weapons, but to current light levels. And let's think about these new strikes we got back. So the Nexus, okay, it has the Vault of Glass mechanics built into the end. And for some reason, I always get the version of the Nexus where there's no cleansing involved. It's the one where you got to use the relic to take down the shield. Now, I know I'm not a lore master. Go to My Name is Bife, my co-host on Guardian Radio, of course. He's the lore master, but I believe the Vex cannot take that technology out of the Vault of Glass, but it's obvious they have. So I'm thinking, okay, that's the hint that, okay, Vault of Glass coming back. Then if when you fire up the new Omnigull strike, she brought herself back from the dead, okay? Could she be coming back to somehow bring Crota back from the dead? And then I'm thinking, okay, the next hint would be Tanix perfected. Perhaps we would get a Prison of Elders Skull-ass Sivified version at the appropriate light level. You know, they'd bump up the light levels. But no hints or anything at King's Fall coming back. And I don't know, do people want King's Fall coming back? I did it last week, and it was a blast. And obviously, when it was in its prime, that raid got exhausting. But at the same time, from not doing it in over a year, it was a lot of fun. So those are some hints I'm thinking, okay, Nexus says Vault of Glass is coming back. The Omnigull Strike is saying Crota's End might be coming back. And I get a feeling that the Tanix Perfected is saying they're going to bring back, because I think they're going to bring back everything and just have one last hoorah before the sequel to Destiny. Okay, so here's everything back. The light levels got majorly bumped up. When I was talking with Scott Taylor at PlayStation Experience, I was telling him my hypothesis. I was like, bump the light level up to 500-600, because just give us something to grind for and make us just grind all spring, all summer, until the sequel to Destiny comes out. But one thing I think is just a glitch. I was by Ikora Ray the other day, and she made a comment. She said, Oryx has been banished from the system, but he's not destroyed, or something to that matter. But I think she's been saying that for a while, so I think Oryx is quite dead, especially when you see the end of King's Fall. But what I really want to talk about is if they want to hype up the sequel to Destiny. So last year when, let's back up to Taken King. The official reveal for Taken King was at E3. Activision brought me out there, I was able to play on the new subclasses, record it. So I get a feeling we'll get a leak prior to E3. I don't think, maybe a formal announcement. You know, I still get a feeling that the Rise of Iron poster was leaked on purpose, okay, before we actually saw the trailer and everything. So at E3, we'll probably get the formal announcement. But how cool would this be, okay? Bungie, if you really want to hype up the sequel to Destiny, make Destiny, Destiny 1, the first game, lead into Destiny 2. What if in the springtime, when we get maybe an April update or so forth, and then again, that's not confirmed or anything, that's just me thinking out loud, we have to get some sort of a April update just like they did last year, make it so that either live events or the old raids, everything leads into the sequel to Destiny 2. Because think about it, if they drop the trailer, okay, and we get a premise of what the sequel to Destiny is going to be about, and they want to build up hype, give us back everything, but also make it so that when they bring everything back, it somehow leads into the story. Like, we get a vague story or a vague just basis of what the sequel is going to be about, but let us grind and kind of work through things to start to understand what we're going to entail in the sequel. You know what I mean? Like, kind of finish Destiny. Finish off the first Destiny, but have a lead in to Destiny 2. So we're playing Destiny 1, we're playing the game, and we're doing things that's going to like lead us into the story or what's going to happen in the sequel to Destiny. What do you guys think about that? Let me know in the comment section. Because I am one of the folks that wants a fresh start in the sequel to Destiny. I want brand new characters. I want to start from nothing. No gear. But then again, okay, if you want to bring our characters over just aesthetically, pick one or two, or maybe all three of them. But when it comes to gear and everything, I just literally want to start from scratch. And I think they learned their lesson that we, you know, you give us a light level, you give us a character level, level 40, level 29, then it would start, whatever. We're going to hit it really fast. That's our problem with this game. It's not necessarily Bungie. It's we eat through content really quickly. And Eric Hirschberg, the CEO of Activision, did acknowledge that. And their goal in the sequel to Destiny is to streamline stuff so that we don't have these types of content droughts. So let's hope they deliver on that. And then lastly, so that's pretty much it. That's all I want to cover, guys. Let me know in the comment section what you guys think about the lead-in. And then also the hints, maybe these three new strikes are prized. Are they going to give us back Crota's End, Vault of Glass, bring back the Prison of Elders to relevant light levels, and give us Skolas perfected or Sivified? No word about King's Fall. And then lastly, I just want to finish on the strike scoring system. Man, I love it, but there's really no incentive if you think about it. They just give you more Vanguard rep. I kind of wish that the Vanguard bounties, the new ones with the strike scoring, had its own loot table. Now, granted, the three that you get from Zavala every week, yes, there's a new armor set, and you have a chance of getting an icebreaker, but there's no loot set, really, so to speak, for doing all those. You just get some extra Vanguard rep, that's it. But I feel like when we have the sequel, we're going to have the strike scoring, hopefully, and give us more incentive, give us more stuff to grind for, because what do we like in this game? The reason why we keep coming back to it is we're grinders. We want loot, we want gear, we want toys, we want new exotics. So anyway, I've babbled through this video enough. Do me a favor, drop a like in this video, only if you see fit. Follow me on the Twitter, @MesaSean. Check out my stream, usually on YouTube. And that's it. I'm out of here, like Vladimir.